We've been searching for signs of extraterrestrial life for the past 50 plus years, and so far we have found no evidence of anything beyond our planet. But what are we searching for? We are framed by our own human expectations, our current technology and understanding of the universe, and the physics that we believe make it work. In other words, we are looking for what we might expect other beings like us might send using technology that we know about. The first problem is that if we got a signal or a message from ET, could we understand it? Would it be a signal broadcast and intended for other civilizations like us that might contain clues to help decipher it, or would it be just a byproduct of something they are doing going about their everyday existence? Take our output into the cosmos, for example. For the past 100 years or so, we have been accidentally transmitting radio waves into space, from the most basic spark transmissions of Marconi's first tests, to high-speed data communications with satellites of today and everything else in between. Nearly all of this information has been intended for us, other than the intentional signals which we have sent out, and not for extraterrestrial beings. For any ETs discovering our transmissions, assuming that they are nearby and not hearing those first spark tests of Marconi, it would be a bit like us stumbling across ancient writings in an unknown language and trying to figure out what the message is saying. In fact, there are still a handful of ancient writing systems here on Earth, like Linear A, that we still can't decipher, and they were written by modern humans just a few thousand years ago. Any message from ET will be coming from a civilization which had evolved in a radically different way from us. Another example we might find on Earth is that of dolphins, whale, and elephant communications. We know they're intelligent and that they communicate using some form of language, but we have little to no idea of what they are saying to each other. Theorists believe that whilst decoding any message from ET may be extremely difficult, by looking at the way the message was sent could lead to clues on how to decipher it. The very fact that it is being received via a radio transmission, and that would have been encoded with some sort of signal in some way, mean that ET may not be that different from us, in that they understand about space, the universe, how to send signals, and that they must also then know about maths and so on and so forth. This could lead to possible extraterrestrial Rosetta Stones that could unlock further meaning in the message. The second problem is that the distance between us and any potentially advanced species is huge. We also have to be looking in the right place at the right time. If a signal only lasts for a few seconds or minutes and our receivers are looking in a different direction, we'll miss it completely. Or it might be so weak because of the distance that we might not detect it in the first place. If we were very lucky, we might receive a signal that is less than 100 light years away, but it is far more likely to come from thousands or tens of thousands of light years away, because that's where most of the stars and potential life-supporting planets are in our galaxy. This effectively rules out any realistic chance of communication. Assuming we got lucky and we received a signal today from a local source approximately 100 light years away. If we sent a reply within a few months after figuring out whether or not to respond, it would be another 100 years before they got our reply. A 200 year round trip, that's even if they are still listening or even able to listen. And this brings us to the third problem, in that it would be highly unlikely that we will be at the same stage of technological development as ET. The earlier distance problem also compounds this. If we received a radio signal from a source 10,000 light years away, that would have been sent whilst our ancestors were still living in caves, and ET may have been then as technologically advanced as we are now. It's hard to imagine where we might be in 10,000 years' time at our current rate of development, but the chances are that we'll have discovered a radically different way of communicating across the vast distances of space. The extraterrestrials that sent the message 10,000 years ago may now be using technologies which are way in advance of our understanding or ability to pick up, and that's why it might be so quiet out there. We might be doing with radio what is the technological equivalent of trying to pick up an email with a couple of cans and a piece of string. We are listening for ET using a basic method of modulated radio waves, which would be far too slow for any advanced spacefaring species to use. I can't say what methods they might use. It may be interdimensional or quantum entanglement. We won't know until it's discovered. But whatever it is, it will have to be faster than light to make it useful over the vast distances between star systems, which also puts it out of the realm of our current understanding of physics. So whilst we have nothing better than radio, I personally don't think that we will find any signals from ET. Even though I do think there are many advanced civilizations out there amongst the stars in our own galaxy. If we do find anything with radio, it will probably be from ETs that are too far away for any communication with, and probably in the same situation as us. Isolated pockets of intelligence that haven't yet figured out how to get from one star to another within the lifetime of the crew. Everything else will be way, way ahead of us, and may not really be interested in communicating with a species until we can communicate with them at their level. Just as we don't go backwards when we discover a lost tribe. And as always, thanks for watching. Please subscribe, rate, and share.